Hello there, everybody. Hi, welcome to today's live lesson. Nice to see you here with us. I can see some people already saying hi in the chat. So please say hello. Hello from Romania. Hi, Irina. How are you today? My name's Jo, and I'm in France, if you haven't joined us before. So yeah, let us know, where are you joining us from? And how are you today? Dipthi in Sri Lanka, hi, hello, welcome back. Ramonda in Egypt, hi to you, hello. Soko in Mongolia, hi, how are you doing? I can see some people coming up as Facebook user. If you'd like to go into settings and allow us to show your name, then we can put your name on the screen if you like. Lizzie, hi from Ecuador. I can see Carmen has joined us. Hi, and Julia, hello, greetings from Myanmar. Bim, namaste from Nepal. Okay, lots of different countries today. Hi there, Carmen, how are you? From Angola, Ted from Myanmar, William from Angola. Hi, welcome. Welcome everybody to our lesson. Let's have a look in a bit more detail at what we're going to do today. What are we doing in today's session? Okay, so today we're going to be talking about films and series. So we're going to have an introduction to that topic. Then our language focus for today is going to be adjectives for describing films. We'll have a quiz to see how much you remember. And then it's going to be your turn to review a film or a series. Okay, so we're going to practice writing a short review today in the comments. So hopefully we'll have lots of recommendations of different films and series by the end of today's lesson. Okay, so I can see lots more people joining us from many different countries, Kazakhstan, Thailand, Ukraine, Pakistan, Mexico, hi Manuel in Tenerife, Puyan in Iran. Okay, so welcome everybody that's joining us today. Okay, so just remember, the more you participate and the more you put in the comments, the more you'll learn. So I hope to read lots and lots of your comments today. Okay, so shall we get started with our topic, which is films and series? And I think we've got a question for you. Right, here it is. What's your favorite film or TV show? Okay, so maybe quite hard to say like one favorite. So it could be like one of your favorites or your favorite that you've watched recently, something you like. So a film or a TV show, it's either your favorite or one that you like. What is it for you? Okay, my personal favorite is Friends. Oh my goodness, from Antarctica, says Sheikh. That is interesting. Maybe that's the first person we've had with us from Antarctica. Okay, so as I just said, my favorite is Friends. Irina, my favorite film is As Good As It Gets. Okay, thank you for sharing that, Irina. Okay, I can see some other films here now. Boom, Titanic. Okay, a classic. That one I find so sad. What else have we got? The Tudors. Okay, so a historical one there. Okay, I can see Karate Kid, The Last Samurai, The Paper House, Doctor House, Friends. Okay, John Logan, The Last Samurai, The Gifted, right? I can see How I Met Your Mother, Oppenheimer. Okay, that was a big one last year, wasn't it? Film, 12 Angry Men, TV show, I missed that. Mohammed, Game of Thrones, okay, another classic series. My favorite TV show is The Voice, so that's a singing competition, I think. Rolling Stones, one of my favorite TV shows is Friends, it's always classic. Oh, I agree with you there, Rolling Stones. That's one of my favorites too. The Scent of the Woman, The Scent of a Woman starring Al Pacino. Okay, says Manuel. I can see Notting Hill, Little Women, The Mentalist, Big Lebowski. Oh, I remember seeing that a long time ago. Yeah, that's a good one. Grey's Anatomy, Sopranos, more Friends fans, Brooklyn Nine-Nine and Friends. Okay, I can see Harry Potter. Wow, okay, lots of really different kinds of films and TV shows. So we'd say, could say that some of them, they're different genres that we've mentioned, okay? So something like Friends, what's that? What kind of genre is that? That's a comedy, or maybe we could say more specifically for Friends, it's a sitcom, like a situation comedy. What other genres, how many genres of films or series do you know in English? Haha, somebody's saying, where are the Office fans? Yeah, I like that too. That's another funny one, isn't it? Okay, so what different genres? So when we say a genre, we mean like a type, a kind. So something like a comedy or a sitcom. What other ones can we think of? Can you type those in the chat? Adventure, says Maria. Yes, okay, good. Idris, fantasy. Okay, so somebody said Harry Potter. That's an example of fantasy, isn't it? Ramonda says a sitcom. Yes. Okay, I can also see some people saying, oh, historical, says Maria. Yeah, somebody said the Tudors earlier on, so I guess that's historical. Historical drama, we could say maybe crime, says Arena. Yes. Lots of people saying sci-fi. Maria, science fiction, exactly. Or we can say sci-fi for short. Rolling Stone says horror, sci-fi, romance, and historical. Should we say historical drama, maybe, for that? Lowly Love, soap opera. That's what we call those, a soap opera. Okay, so I can see biography, drama, documentary, mystery, rom-com. Yeah, so that's when it's like romantic and funny at the same time. That's a rom-com. Political films, action, disaster films. Oh, yes. Thrillers, animation. Yes, okay, so cartoons and animation. Manuel's got quite a few. Action, Western, rom-com, historical films, thrillers, science fiction, and on, exactly. We could go on and on. There are lots of different genres of films. You've probably got a favourite genre, or maybe genres that you don't like at all. I don't like horror. That's a genre that I never watch. Far too scary for me. Okay, so now we've had a look at some different genres and what your favourite TV shows or films are. So what adjectives could you use to describe your favourite film or TV show? Can you think of some adjectives to describe it? Musicals, that's another one, isn't it? Yeah, the tragedies of William Shakespeare. Great ideas there. Okay, thanks, Phoebes. Yeah, musicals. Manuel says horror films are only for teens. Yeah, that was the only time I ever watched horror films, when I was a teenager. I can't watch them now. Wonderful. Okay, so maybe you could tell me which film or series you're describing. That would be interesting to know which one you think is wonderful. Or just write some adjectives. Wasana says exciting. Okay, there's an example for you. Stranger Things is, Stranger Things is scary. Too scary for me. I don't like Stranger Things. I wonder if you do. Do you like Stranger Things? And how would you describe it? I said my favorite was Friends, so I could say that's funny, maybe a bit silly. Stranger Things is implausible. That's a great adjective, Manuel. So if something is implausible, it means, you know, we can't really believe it. It couldn't really happen. Okay, I can see hilarious, boring, intriguing, mind-blowing, compelling. Outlander is amazing. compelling, far-fetched. Okay, great. Stranger Things is mind-blowing, says Manel. Addictive. Yeah, some series are addictive. You just want to watch another episode and another one and another one. Boring, thrilling, romantic. Okay, Friends is a funny film or funny series, we could say. Okay, great ideas here for your adjectives. So I've seen there. Okay, so we've got kind of basic adjectives like boring or interesting or funny. And then I've also seen some more kind of like interesting adjectives. So we've got some of them here now on the screen. So some basic ones like good or bad. And then some more interesting ones like heartwarming or action-packed or gripping. So can you have a look at these adjectives that you can see on the screen and tell me which of these words would you use to describe a film that you like? Okay, could you use these, or if you want, you can use your own too. Which of these words that you can see here would you use to describe a film that you like? So lots of them there. Thrilling, hilarious, ridiculous, dull, predictable. What do you think? So we want positive ones, things that you like. And are there any words here that you don't know? If you don't know the meanings of some of these words, you can ask us in the comments. So say, can you tell me what, for example, heartwarming means? Wasana says, superb, good, interesting, clever, funny, stunning, heartwarming. Okay, yeah, heartwarming, that's something that makes you, you just feel really good when you watch it, makes you feel happy. Okay, any others that are for films that you like? What do you think? Oh, somebody's asking, what is cliched? I'll come back to that in a second. Okay, yeah. Marta says, what is cliched? So if something is cliched, then it means that, you know, we've already heard it or we've already seen it lots of times before. It's not interesting. You know, we know what to expect and it's kind of just quite boring, really. So we could say that a film is cliched, or maybe dialogue is cliched if we just, I've heard those kind of things so many times before. Okay, so what have we got? 12 Angry Men is great, clever, unpredictable, and an interesting movie. Okay, so that's a film that you like. Somebody's saying predictable. Predictable. Now we're describing a film that you don't like. Okay, so predictable, that could be, because predictable is when we just know what's going to happen. It's not interesting. Repetitive. Yes, okay, repetitive. That means when it's just the same thing again and again. That's not very interesting. Phoebes, what does action-packed mean? Okay, good question. So when there's lots of action in a film, you know, there's lots of things happening and it's really exciting, we could say it's action-packed. You know, like, for example, James Bond, you know, when he's like having one adventure after the other and running here and there and doing all sorts of things, that's action-packed. Mariam, what does dull mean? Dull is the same as boring. So if something is dull, it's just really boring and there's nothing interesting in it. I don't want to watch it. Okay, Julia, Mission Impossible. Yes, good example of an action-packed movie. An action-packed and thrilling film that captivated all of my attention from beginning to end. Yeah, it captivated your attention. You could say it's captivating. What does gripping mean, please? Okay, another good question. So if something is gripping, it means that it holds your attention. You know, you really want to know what's going to happen next. It's just really, gripping. It's just interesting and makes you want to know more. So we've had action-packed. Shallow, somebody's saying. Is it okay to use Bosch instead of writing interesting? I think probably if you're going to write a film review, probably you could use interesting. How can we describe a movie that makes you think a lot and gives you like a new perspective in life? I like that question. What about something like thought-provoking? If something makes you think, you could say it's thought-provoking. So we've had a look now at words which are for films we like and films we don't like. Okay, that's the word that I've just mentioned there, thought-provoking. Somebody there said Groundhog Day is repetitive but nice. Yeah, I've just remembered that film. It's the same thing happens every day, isn't it? But I suppose that's the point of that film. Okay, so the films that we like, those are the ones. What does thrilling mean? Just really, really exciting. Yeah, if you get thrills, it means you're on the edge of your seat with excitement. So all of these words here that you can see in white, I think we could use to talk about films we like. Thrilling, good, superb, hilarious. That's what I would say about Friends. Exciting, clever, interesting, action-packed, heartwarming, stunning, gripping, funny. Okay, so stunning we would maybe use to talk about like scenery in a film. Oh, it's so beautiful, it's stunning. Okay, and what about the ones that we don't like? So that would be bad, cliched, ridiculous, boring, predictable, silly, long, and dull. Now, shocking and scary, that really depends, I think, on your point of view. So if you like horror films, I think you would like if you said that they were shocking or scary, that would be a good thing. But if you're like me and you don't like scary films, then I would say that I would use those to talk about films that I don't like. Where can cliché be used? So you could we're going to move on to this in a little while, Azael, but we could talk about cliched being like the plot, so what happens in the film, or maybe what the people say is cliched. You've heard it all before. It's nothing new for you. Dan, Merlin is riveting. Yeah, okay, riveting. We had gripping before. Riveting, that sort of means the same thing, isn't it? Okay. So lots of different adjectives that we've got there. So let's just have a look if we put those into the two different categories there of good or bad. Good, superb, thrilling, interesting, clever, action-packed, exciting, heartwarming, stunning, funny, gripping, hilarious. Bad, okay, ridiculous, cliched, boring, predictable, long, and silly. Okay, when we say long, I suppose we mean like we're thinking it's too long. So I don't know if you've seen Oppenheimer. I didn't watch Oppenheimer because I heard it was very long and I thought it might be too long for me. But other people loved that it was long because they enjoyed it all the way through. Simone, what is dull? Dull is a synonym for boring. Okay, so who and what makes up the film? So we've got the cast, the setting, the plot, the characters, the dialogue, and the director. So those are like really basic film vocabulary. When you want to talk about a film, that's the kind of vocabulary that you can use. So let's see which is which. What do these words actually mean? So can you type in the chat? Number one, the is what happens in the film, and choose one of those words. The is what happens in the film. Okay, so you can do one, two, and three together if you like. What happens in the film? That's number one. Number two, the are the people that the film is about. And number three, the are the actors who perform in the film. So a small difference between two and three. Okay, Zeboniso says number one is the setting and number two is the characters. Okay, so the setting, That is more like where it happens and when it happens. Okay, the director is what happens in the film. The director is a person, actually. Manal says the plot. Okay, who agrees with Manal that number one, the plot is what happens in the film? What do you think? Eva agrees that it's the plot. So does Idris. And Olivia too. Okay, so I think you have got the right answer there. Anybody that said the plot for number one, that's correct. Wasana has the plot. Okay, you've got number two is the characters, the people that the film is about. Okay, and number three, the cast are the actors. Right, okay, so number two and three are similar, aren't they? So the people that the film is about, so those aren't real people. They are the, as Wasana says, the characters. So I'm thinking again of Friends. So I'm thinking the characters are Rachel and Ross, etc. And the people who actually, the real people that act those are the cast. Okay, let's go on now then to number four. The decides how the film is made. The is the time and place where the film takes place. And number six, the is what the people say. What do you think are the correct answers here now then to number four, five, and six? Okay, Irina, quick to get in the comments as usual. That's great. Idris is number four, the director decides how the film is made. Okay, I could see Irina agreed there. Okay, I can see four. Anna says it's the director. Okay, lots of people are saying number four is the director. Okay, I think that's good. Irina, number five, the setting is the time and place where the film takes place. Uh-huh. Manal agrees there with director and setting. And Carmen says the director decides. Uh-huh. And what about what the people say? Manuel says it's the dialogue. And so does Seiya, says it's the dialogue. Uh-huh, Manuel. Good. Okay, so these are the correct answers. So the plot is what happens in the film. The characters are the people the film is about. The cast are the actors. So all the actors together we call the cast. The director is the person who makes all the big decisions. The setting is the time and place. And the dialogue is what the people say. Okay, so now we've got these different like components and parts that make up the film. What adjectives can we use to describe them? What do you think? Okay, so here we've got some adjectives that we've had before. And I think we've got some more now, some other ones. So again, if there's ones that you don't understand, ask me in the chat. So can you explain fun-loving, for example? Okay, so do just ask me any that you don't know and tell me which. First of all, let's look at the plot. So the plot, let's remember that's what happens in the film. So we could say the plot is what? What could we say about the plot? And just don't forget to ask me if you've got any questions. Samira says the plot is full of twists. Right. Okay. So twists, that's when things change and maybe you don't expect them to. Olivia, the plot, fast pace. Yeah. Things happen quickly. We don't get bored when the plot is fast paced. Somebody's asked to explain that. So that's when all of the, you know, the actions and things that happen, it moves very quickly. So that makes it probably quite exciting and interesting. Eunice, what does witty mean? Okay, witty is when something is funny, but in a like in a clever way. So when somebody, usually maybe we could say the dialogue is witty, or we could say people are witty when they say witty things. So when they say things that make you laugh, but because they make you think and they're clever. The plot was fun loving. Sandrella, I think we probably would use fun loving to talk about people rather than things, because these people love fun. So I probably would use that for characters and actors. Okay, Wasana says, far-fetched, fast-paced, realistic, witty, complicated, dark, full of twists, convincing, slow-moving. Okay, I think that all good ideas there. Manuel says, the plot that's full of twists makes me crazy. And a witty plot is a Woody Allen film. Right, yeah, Woody Allen films are a lot, the dialogues are important in them and often quite funny and clever. Sabrina, slow moving. Yes, a plot can be slow moving. That's obviously the opposite of fast paced. Okay, so the ones in yellow there. It looks like fun loving is yellow, but that one is not the bright yellow ones. So full of twists, far fetched, gripping, fast paced, heartwarming, complicated, or slow moving. I think that most of you got those. Okay, shall we move on now to the characters? Characters or actors? What do you think? Which adjectives could describe characters or actors? Somebody saying the dialogue is natural. Yeah. Okay. What do you think we could use? Which adjectives can we use to talk about the characters? Flawed. Yeah. Does everybody know the meaning of flawed? If a character is flawed, it means that they make mistakes. You know, they're not perfect. That probably makes them more interesting, if they have flaws or if they're flawed. Fun loving, right? Yeah, so I think a lot of in a comedy you might expect to find fun loving characters. Charismatic. Okay, so if somebody has charisma, then they are quite attractive, people like them. Characters are charismatic. Yes, lovable and fun loving. Yes, Manel, I agree with those. So if they're lovable, that means we love them. We get attached to those characters. Okay, lots of good ideas for the characters or the actors. Okay, so what have we got? Convincing, lovable, fun-loving, flawed, and charismatic. I've seen we could say realistic as well. I think that would fit there too. Realistic characters. Dark, yes. Yeah, so if a character is dark, then maybe there's something maybe evil or threatening about them. Okay, so that just leaves us with the dialogue. So that must be all of the ones that are left. Let me know if you have any questions about that vocabulary. I can see somebody saying courageous and adventurous characters. Yeah, those are other words. So do add other adjectives that you know that would fit in the chat. The dialogue can be realistic and natural. Yes. We've also got, somebody's asking again, what's witty? Okay, so witty is funny in a clever way. So the dialogue could be witty. If it makes us laugh and makes us think, oh yeah, that's clever, then we would say that's witty. So the dialogue, natural, witty, realistic, stilted or wooden. So if something is stilted, it means it doesn't sound natural. It sounds quite like stiff. Snappy, you know, that goes quickly. And cliched, we've already said cliché is when you just know what to expect. There's nothing new if it's cliched. Stilted or wooden. Yeah, so if something is stilted, you know, it's not smooth, it's not natural. So that's why we could say that dialogue is stilted or wooden. Or maybe you could say that the actor was stilted or wooden if they didn't seem like they didn't seem natural. Okay, let's see. Any more questions about the vocabulary? Or maybe we'll move on to the quiz to see how much you remember. Realistic script becomes a thought-provoking reaction for the spectators. Yes, exactly. Okay, so if the script is realistic, then that makes for an interesting film. Okay, so now it's time for our quiz. So as usual, type your answers into the comments. What do you think, either A, B, or C? So the plot was original and unpredictable. It was full of A, twists, B, turns, or C, happenings. What do you think? What did we see a little while ago? Full of twists, says Olivia. Lots of people say twists. A. Irina says twists. I can see a lot of agreement for this one. Zayad also says twists. Eunice too. Okay. Most people think that it's twists, and you're right. Okay, so the plot was original and unpredictable. It was full of twists. Irina's given us an example. In Pulp Fiction, the plot is full of twists. Exactly. Things happen that we don't expect. Things change. Okay, have you seen Oppenheimer? I think I mentioned just a little while ago, I didn't see it because I thought it seemed too long. But I've heard that Cillian Murphy was really in the role of Oppenheimer. So this was the actor that played the main part. Was he A, convinced, B, convincing, or C, convince? What could we say there? So we're saying that the actor was really, we really believed that he was Oppenheimer. Was he convinced, convincing, or convince? C, says Sidad. Convince. Okay. Anna says convincing. I see Ramonda agreed with me. Too long for me. Cold says convincing. Yes, exactly, Ramonda. I think I would like to see it, but it did seem quite long to watch in the cinema. Was really convincing in the role of Oppenheimer. Mm-hmm. Eunice agrees it's convincing. Irina also says, I haven't seen Oppenheimer yet. And the answer is convincing. Yes. So we say that something or someone is convincing. We need ing on the end of the adjective. I was convinced. And this actor was convincing. So if you remember there, the difference between ed and ing on adjectives. What about Barbie? Did any of you see Barbie? I enjoyed that film, and I thought that some of the dialogue in Barbie was really A, wisdom, B, pretty, or C, witty. What do you think? What's the correct answer there? Some of the dialogue, so remember the dialogue, that's what the characters say to each other. A, wisdom, B, pretty, or C, witty. What do you think? Okay. Alien says witty. Okay. Irina, I enjoyed Barbie too. Carmen, I don't like Barbie. Okay, we've got some differences of opinion about the film. Thayad says witty. Witty again. Okay. I think lots of people are answering C or witty. Are we right? Was the dialogue witty? Yes. Okay. So it was kind of funny and clever at the same time. Okay. So well done for the quiz. So now what we're going to do is try to think of this vocabulary we've had about films, so the plot, the cast, etc., and the adjectives. And it's going to be your turn to write a review. So just a small review. So what you can do is type your review and maybe just keep typing, and then you can then click send at the end and we'll have your little review to read out on the screen. Okay, so shall we do this together? Let's write a film review together. So this is the first thing that you need to write. Okay, type the name of the film or the series, the genre, and a one sentence summary of what it's about. Okay, so nothing really long at this stage, so just something really short. So I can give you my example, which is Friends. So the name of my series is Friends. The genre is a sitcom. And just in one sentence, I would say it's about the relationships and the everyday lives of six good friends. Okay, so that would be what I would put there for this first part. Okay, so have you all typed something here? Okay. So we'll ask three questions and don't press send on your review until we get to question three, so that we can receive all of your review together. Okay, so so for example, Olivia said the notebook is the beauty and the harsh realities of life. Good, but keep that, Olivia, and we're going to add to it. Somebody's asking in the meantime, what does wisdom mean? Wisdom means having knowledge, having lots of knowledge and intelligence gained from your experience. Okay, so don't post your review just yet. Keep your review, because we're going to do it in three parts, okay? So post it at the end. Let's do number two. So tell us about the setting. So still, we're talking about always about the same film or series. So tell us about the setting, the main characters, the actors, and if you can, the director. Sometimes we don't know the director, who that is, but if you do know. Okay, so keep typing in your review. So I'll keep telling you about my example. So my example, which is Friends. So the setting is New York City in the 1990s or early 2000s. The main characters are Ross and Rachel, Monica, Chandler, Joey and Phoebe. Lots of actors, the main ones were Jennifer Aniston and David Schwimmer, I suppose, for Ross and Rachel. And the director, I'm not sure about the director of Friends. I'd have to Google that to find out. Okay, but if you know the director, you can put that. And if you don't, no worries. Okay, so give a very brief summary of the plot. So no spoilers. So a spoiler is when you tell people the ending. And they also want to watch it. And so if they know the ending, well, then that's spoilt it for them. So don't give any spoilers. So just briefly summarize the plot without saying exactly what happens at the end. So about the same film, so or series. So mine, Friends, brief summary of the plot. Ross and Rachel get together multiple times. And two of the other main characters get together at the end or before the end of the series. Okay. So, Irina, The Holdovers is a drama. It's about the relationship between a teacher and one of his pupils. Okay. So remember that we're writing a whole review here. Yeah. So we need all of these three things here. We've got the name of the film, the genre, a sentence about what it's about, setting, the main characters and actors, and a very brief summary. The Big Lebowski is a cult comedy devoted to the atmosphere of the end of the 90s in the USA. Okay, thank you, Alexander. I think we've got one more thing to add to our review, actually. Nayad is about a former swimmer. She managed to swim The distance between Havana and Florida. Don't ever give up your dreams. Oh, it's 64 years. Okay, so is that, I haven't seen that, Carmen. I suppose that's a true story. Use adjectives to say why you like it and why people should watch it. Okay, so my adjectives for Friends is I would say it's, I think it's hilarious. Oh, hang on, let me just read Carmen's. Naiad is a biographical film with a supercast, Annette Bening and Jodie Foster. Okay, that sounds great. So remember your adjectives to talk about the plot and the actors and why people should watch it. What sort of people would watch it? Fun-loving people or people who like action films, people who like scary films. Okay, so are you ready with your whole review? Irina, it is set in the USA in 1970 in a boarding school. The main characters are the history teacher, the pupils, and the cook. Alexander Payne is the director. Okay, can you add now, Irina, some adjectives to say why you like it and why people should watch it? Okay, are you ready with your review? So if you've done the whole review together now with all of those components, one, two, three, and four, you can post your review now. I think some people have posted theirs like a little bit at a time. What about the notebook? Olivia has talked about the notebook, the beauty and the harsh realities of life. It's introspective and contemplative. Okay, those are two nice adjectives that we haven't seen yet. Introspective and contemplative. Okay, so they really makes you think then. Dan, Merlin is one of my favorite films. It's a fantasy drama, and the leading characters are Merlin, Arthur, Gaius, and is it Guinevere? Okay, have we got a brief summary of the plot? Let's see. Somebody's saying how to start a film review with a catchy introduction. Okay, so that's something to work on as well. Here we're just doing a really basic and quick review, but you could think of a really catchy way to start it. So the Big Lebowski, the plot happens in LA. The main character, I missed that. I have to wait for that to come around again. I wasn't quick enough. The main characters are Jeff Lebowski, called and who calls himself Dude, his friends, and some characters around another Jeffrey Lebowski, a rich disabled veteran of the Korean War. Okay, great. Thank you, Alexander. So that was for part two. Aquaman is a fiction film which is all about saving a lost kingdom and lost relationships. It happens underwater with Aquaman as the main character, played by Jason Momoa, and is directed by. I've missed the director. So, Aquaman, I haven't seen this one. Aquaman is the main character, and it's directed by James Wan. It's action-packed and witty, and it's made for IMAX. Okay, that sounds great, Cold. That sounds like a great film. Have we got some more reviews? Jerry Maguire is a comedy drama film about one sport agent who lost his job but never lost his faith. Story took place in the USA. Tom Cruise starred as the agent. The movie was heartwarming. Let's wait for that to go around again. Tom Cruise starred as the agent who fought for the benefit of athletes. The movie was very heartwarming. And we don't have the rest of your comments. We say somebody starred as something. So Tom Cruise starred as Jerry Maguire. 12 Angry Men is a court drama movie about a jury of 12 men with really different backgrounds discussing a decision of a life sentence. It's a mind-blowing, complicated, and a thought-provoking movie. Yes, I think it's a classic, isn't it, Raimonda? Have we got a few more reviews before we have to finish? Hola. Face Off is my favourite. It's action. It's an action and drama movie. It's got gorgeous actors and some marvellous plots. Okay, marvellous. That's another adjective that we didn't see before. That's a good one. Titanic was amazing. The name of the TV show is Brooklyn Nine-Nine and the genre is sitcom. It's about Jake Peralta and his lovable colleagues, the police. Let's wait for that one. And the police, as they police the NYPD's 99th precinct and solve crimes. The setting is Brooklyn, New York. The main characters are Jake Peralta, etc., etc. I can see the rest of your comment there, Manal. I do love this show. Brooklyn Nine-Nine is an amazing, entertaining, and humorous show, but it also dives into more serious topics. That's great. That's a really nice review. The Boy in the Striped Pajamas is about the innocent friendship between Nazi killer son and a Jewish boy, but it ends in tragedies. Okay. Titanic, that's a popular film, isn't it? It's a romantic or very sad film. Okay, lots of film reviews that I wonder if you saw any that were recommended there by other people that you would like to watch. It's given me some ideas about films and series to watch. Let us know, what film are you going to watch next? What film or series are you looking forward to watching next? And will you check out any of the recommendations that you've read today? I'm planning to go to the cinema this evening, actually, and I want to see the film about Bob Marley, which it's only just come out last week where I live. So I don't know if any of you have seen that yet. And if you did have, what did you think of it? So what films or series are you looking forward to watching next? And will you check out any of the recommendations that you've read today? Okay, Ramonda's talking about The Office. Has anybody seen that? So she recommends that to you. Comedy show about a group of colleagues with different personalities. They're really hilarious characters. It's amusing and witty. Okay, I like that too. The American version of The Office. Let me know. Have you seen that and do you like it? Moana 2. Okay, is that what you're going to watch next? Manuel says the Bob Marley story will soon come out all around the world. Will you watch it, Manuel? Probably Willy Wonka, says Leela. Ah, yes, I saw that recently. I enjoyed that. I'm looking forward to seeing Zone of Interest. Okay, Irina. Manuel says, I haven't seen Pulp Fiction yet and I plan to watch it this weekend. Yeah, I saw that a long time ago. I think I'd like to watch that again. Alexander says, Oppenheimer, Barbie, and other Oscar-nominated movies. Malu Malu says, Departures, 2009, fantastic Japanese movie. Okay. Wasanda says, I crave for groundbreaking kind of movies. I don't like those predictable ones. Yeah, groundbreaking. So you want something that's like brand new, unpredictable, something that you've never seen before. I'm planning to binge watch The House of Dragon. Okay, that's a really good expression. So if you binge watch something, you watch lots and lots of episodes all at once. Somebody said addictive before. So yeah, that's when you binge watch. The Superman Legacy. Okay. Any more recommendations before we finish? Superman, okay, we've had that one. Devil Wears Prada, The Witcher season 3. Okay, so lots of films and series to watch. I'm going to watch 7 tonight. It's a shame I haven't watched it yet. Do you watch in English when you watch things, for example, on when you watch series? Do you watch the English version? That would be interesting to know. Okay, well, I hope that some of the adjectives that we've looked at today were new or interesting for you and that will help you to talk about films and series in English. We'll be back next week. Zina will be here next week with another live lesson. And in the meantime, thanks for participating. Thanks for joining in. And I've really enjoyed reading all about your favorite films and series. Okay, so thank you for coming and I'll see you again soon.